So what I'm going to talk about a little bit, but only a couple of minutes, is really some aspects of business models and business aspects of the network API business. The time would never ever be sufficient to discuss this really in depth. So there are a lot of topics. I just want to make some remarks where we think are some very interesting and critical aspects to discuss in this area. And definitely would be more than happy to follow up with you. We have a white paper, which you can download from the internet, from our GSMA portal, but also in case you would like to have more in-depth discussion with us or with my colleagues, let us know. We are more than happy to do so. This picture describes what the whole network API stuff is about. Yeah, what we see is what customers make use of and what's happening on smartphones, but not just on smartphones, also on other devices, is people make more and more use of various kinds of third-party applications and services, complementary to the classical telecommunication services like voice, like messaging. And if you compare in terms of percentages, obviously consumers spend more and more time in these kinds of services, and from a percentage perspective, less in the core operator retail services. But the important thing to know is many of these third-party use cases and these third-party applications make use and can benefit from capabilities which also operators can deliver. And my colleague Manfred will tell you a little bit later what developers and software partners told us, what these capabilities are, and what to what extent they really think they can benefit from this, which is very exciting. So for the operators, obviously, there is an opportunity to be the ones to deliver these capabilities to the third parties, to the partners, to the software players, to the developers, to the brands, and to deliver their capabilities, their core services through software-based use cases to their own retail customers eventually. So also, third-party software-based use cases can be regarded as a sales and delivery channel from an operator perspective of the core operator services to the partners. Yeah, and there are two different kinds of scenarios. So these capabilities can be consumed in third-party software-based applications running on the phone, running in the browser, a chat function in a multiplayer online game or whatever this is. Or it is happening outside any application. It's consumed by a service provider, for instance, by a customer care application. Could be by an airline sending out an SMS notification to you when the plane is late, something like this. So these two different scenarios we have. In terms of the business benefits from an operator perspective at this point in time, there are some very different business benefits you could define as your objective, what you want to achieve with network APIs. There's a classical one, which we know very well from the value-added services business, which is well established since many, many years, which is generating direct wholesale revenues. Means charge the service provider, charge your software partner for getting access to the services per transaction, per voice minute, whatever this is. So that's well established. More and more what we see becomes important and relevant also for the telecommunications industry, really regard the third parties, the use cases, the applications as a sales and delivery channel, and deliver this to your retail customers, and by this strengthen the relevance of the operator core services for your customers. Because customers make use of these services then not just natively on the device as the retail operator service, I send you an SMS and you give me a call, but they're consumed in many various kinds of use cases, which increases the consumption of these services and makes the services, and therefore the operator, much more relevant to the consumer as a full service provider and not just as a data provider. And also if you think about, let's say, new services, RCS join, for instance, that can really boost the adoption of these services because people make use of these services because they want to make use of this application, which is nice and attractive and well known. However, that could mean that you do not generate direct revenues, direct wholesale revenues, but that your retail business case benefits from this. However, we know that this is typically extremely difficult to model. You need to have a lot of assumption how this really benefits or how your retail business case benefits out of it. But in case that you really think it through, the benefit of a network API business on the retail business side can be significantly higher than you could ever achieve by the direct wholesale revenues. So, and also we did a recent industry survey amongst quite a couple of operators, which business objectives they favor and which they want to go for. Interesting, really, that's really split. And we have here the operators who favor the wholesale revenues as the main objective, the ones who want to strengthen the retail business side and the, get the benefit out of the retail business case. And those ones on the most right-hand side, which simply want to drive innovation, get attractive applications for their customers for differentiation purposes, for instance. And what you see is that, yes, most operators still stick to the wholesale business model as their primary business objective. But already, quite a lot also move into this field and say, look, we have recognized that the relevance on the wholesale side is really a very important business objective for us, and they go for this. And also quite a lot of them think about this as a source of innovation, get external innovation to your customers. So that's pretty interesting. And I just wanted to point to a white paper which we are still compiling. So in a couple of weeks, we will have a white paper covering all this industry survey, which you can download from our portal, or if you leave us our your contact, we would be happy to send you the full white paper eventually. So the business model is, I think, very easy. If you want to go for your wholesale benefit, you get the money from the developer, from your software partner. If you want to go for retail benefit, you get the money from the subscriber, either as a premium service, you generate direct revenues from the subscriber, or it's simply part of the tariff. And if it's a bundled tariff where messaging, RCS, whatever is bundled in, yeah, it's part of the bundle, so you probably will not get an on-top revenue on this, but you motivate your customer to purchase and subscribe to this high-value bundle tariff rather than the low-value tariffs or, in the extreme case, the data-only tariff.